Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Welcome if you're new. I'm Stacy. Woo! And today we are going to be painting this little cocktail. I thought we would make it a little fun and festive. It's supposed to be orange with oranges, but maybe we'll add a little bit of sparkle to the painting. I don't know. Let's just see what happens. I hope you're all doing well. I'm going to start by giving the paper a nice spritz. This is 300 pound Stonehenge paper that I've been working on for a while now. I've got several large sheets, 10 I think, and I cut them all down into smaller pieces. The colors you're seeing right there is, where is it? Bits of this got thrown about the space today and kind of some of it landed on here. Clearly it's powdery and I was making a background for the big painting I'm doing, and yeah, clearly it got on here too. Sorry about that. So let's start with my Princeton Neptune round. Maybe this also has pigment in it still. Round number 8. We'll go ahead and spread that around a bit. Maybe that'll influence our piece. We'll just splash around some pale blue like that. Bit of yellow. Water like that. Wherever it's too bright, we can just mix it together. And my thought was to just make this a light, fun kind of, I guess, festive. This is that golden color that I love. That pumpkin spice is what it is, and it's got mica in it, so it'll add a bit of sparkle, which is what I want. Okay. Then down here, to our tabletop, loosely. Does not need to be exact or perfect. I mean, it can be if that's how you like to paint. Generally, that is, I like a more realistic kind of piece, but today we're just going to have a little bit of fun. This is, what color is this? I think this is it's that wet grizzly. Nope, it's the club brown. Is this one? Some of the mica from the other paint is mixing in with it, which I don't mind. Let's soften that down. Maybe make it a little shadowy in some areas back here. Okay. We go. Let's drop in. I'm going to use this wild salmon color to start with our oranges. This also has mica in it. tint some of that bit of the cup, tint up here, grab some orange. That. Now I think I want to give this a little bit of a dry, and I also would like, I don't have any paper towels back here, so I'll use this to blot up some of this excess water that's puddling. I don't mind a lot of color, I just don't want big puddles. Alright, I'll edit out the drying part so you guys don't have to suffer through that. There we go. I did get a little bit of a flower there, but that's alright. And it did bleed into my leaves a little bit over here. Also alright. I am digging the slight glittery effect that we're getting. I don't know if you guys can see it yet or not, but it is definitely there. Let's go ahead in with a... So, we'll just keep using this brush. Okay, I'm gonna grab my orange, which is actually called pumpkin. I'm gonna add a little bit of pumpkin spice in there, which is right next to the pumpkin. Mix those together. Just maybe a touch of turtle belly. There we go. To give it that more red-orange color. Okay, do we want to wet this first? Not too wet. If you're going to re-wet an area, re-wet the whole area, not just a little bit of it. Otherwise it won't look right when you drop your color in. And I didn't really heavily wet it, I just kind of gently skimmed over the top. We'll go ahead and deepen that. Deeper color underneath the oranges. Like that. Yeah, I dig that. Okay. Well, there's a bit of froth happening from pouring, so we'll scoop some of that out. Nice bright orange. I think I want a brush that isn't going to hold quite as much water. Get a shine spot in right there. I do wish I had a more absorbent piece of fabric. It's alright though. Come in here and get our bit of triangles in. gonna skip out. Shine spot there. Shiny spot there. And then rim of shine right there. Okay. Bring that orange color all the way around like that. Yeah, take that. Get in our orange peels up here. There. I'm just doing little dots to encourage texture and some lack of uniformity in the center. Leave that alone, let that dry. Okay. That. I want some reflective stuff happening in the glass, so we're gonna drop in hints of color already in the piece, already working their way around in here. Table peeking through, but not so dark. There we go. Okay. And I do have too crisp of a border on, like, I'm gonna run this down right to there. that. Bit of orange through there. No. Let's see here. That. Then do a little bit more of the center of this. That. Alright, let's see. Now my leaves. Way too much water. I'm gonna just drop in color. Maybe a touch of green. With a bit of yellow. That's pretty. I like that. Maybe just a touch more green. Oh. Right there. Oh, for crying out loud. Thought I pressed record on that. Clearly I did not. A little bit there. There we go. some fall leaves down here, nothing crazy. Well, that one's drying a bit. We'll do this one that's kind of all wrapped around the other one. Maybe this golden color, this golden pumpkin spice, we can drop that in here and there. Carry that color down here. Only more bold. One there. And then this one can be more yellow. And then, let's see, this one underneath here, falling off the page, can be a bit of brown and gold, I think. Brown and maybe some bronze or this turtle color. Nope. Really caring for that. This one can be what? Another orange one mixed with greens. No, I'll put some bronze on this one. Maybe just a touch of color on this one, like that. Okay, this one back here is going to be yellow and green. Start with yellow. And add a touch of green to it. Here, there, and along that stem. Yeah, I like that. That's pretty. Okay. Which means we can have a little bit of yellow and green running through the reflections in the glass. Like that. That's pretty. Yeah, I like that. Okay. And I want this red, orange, come down. Okay. like that. Okay. Now, I think, and it's in this drawer. Oopsie. Which is tucked way back in this drawer, I think. Yeah, my bleed-proof white's way back in this drawer. I don't know why I don't leave it out. Okay. Let's put this camera back where it goes. And maybe zoom in a bit. Sorry, I'm playing with my close-up camera a little bit here. There we go. We are going to get some bleed-proof white in here. Let's grab a nice glob. Create our froth up here. It's pouring into the glass. And then I need this dried a bit. It is frothing the sides like that. Along the edge of our orange, across the top of it. And then just a little bit coming into the side of that glass like that. Under our orange. There's ice crystals through here, underneath our orange. We have some reflective light happening here. That there's little bits of glints of bubbles and stuff happening. Right there. There we go. And then down here we've got glints. This just helps our orange look more like an orange. Coming around. Thin there. A little lighter there. That. And then just a touch of white here to give us that hot spot of brightness, right? I mean, you could do this any way you want. You don't have to do it the way I'm doing it. You could leave the way the paper. You could use different colors and let your colors do the work for you. I'm just having fun. And there's the sparkly edge of our glass. get there. I've got definite sparkle on the glass. A little rim of white right here, like that, then up top. Beautiful. There we go. Nice. That light background with our glass is totally fine. Let's take our brown, coming down here. Get our table in here. Dark through here, right? Dark under our leaves. I got way too much water. Nice and dark right here. Dry brush right through there. Not nice and dark under the edge of this one. Makes our leaves kind of pop a little bit. That a little edge there. Okay. Let's find the edge of your table. And in the desired direction. Like that. Beautiful. Throw in a crisp edge here and there. Maybe along our glass. Like that. Definitely in here. Right? gonna give our glass a little bit more reflective business. It doesn't have to be everywhere. Just a little dash, a dot, like that. Little touch, touch, touch here and there. Too dark. I'm just gonna dampen it and lift. There we go. There we go. That helps delineate our glass a little bit without adding too much color, right? I'll take a little bit of shiny gold, put it in up here along that rim. Right across there, maybe a bit there, maybe a touch here and a touch there. Just for added interest. And then the bottom of our orange here needs a little attention. Underneath the table. Mixer. Leaves pop. Yeah, come pick it. Should we leave it alone now? Because I could pick at this for way too long. Maybe. Too dark in conjunction with the rest of the piece. It was just a bit too dark, but that's okay. There. Just touches, just bits. Just little bits. I think I'm gonna stop. So I'm getting too nitpicky with it at this point, where I wanted it to be kind of loose and fun. So let's take off our tape. Like so. And then our last piece. And there we go, there's our little cocktail. Well, it was fun to paint. Loose, comfortable. Maybe not realistic, but fun, right? And then that And you can see the sparkle in the back. Right? That's that pumpkin color. I really did. You know what I didn't do is a shadow between these guys. Right here. Where they're overlapping. There. It's the little things in life. Alright. I'm gonna leave it alone. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you like this one? It was fun, right? I don't usually paint liquids, so this was an experiment for me as well. And yeah, I'm kind of digging it. I really like the sparkle. That's really getting me. That little bit of sparkle in the background. Yeah, fun. Okay, let me know what you think in the comments below, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you're new, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!